Hello, Bud here with Budster Productions. In the last episode, I taught you how to feed your plant the nutrients it needs. In this episode, let's talk about protecting your plant from bugs, wind, rain, cold temperatures, and infestations. Your plants will have bugs on it. In order to protect your plant, you will need good pest control, either with chemicals or without. For a pesticide, you will need the following: 16 ounces of water, 1 milliliter of insect spray, a spray bottle that holds 16 ounces of liquid. Do not use the same spray bottle used for nutrients. I recommend Monterey Garden Insect Spray, $10 a bottle. I added the link to the description. In your spray bottle, add 1 milliliter of insect spray to 16 ounces of water and spray the plant leaves, buds, stem, and all around the plant to keep the bad bugs away. Spray only once a month. Do not use pesticides more than 4 times of the plant's life cycle. If you don't want to use pesticides on your plant, you can use good bugs like ladybugs or praying mantises as a natural pesticide. Buy ladybugs or praying mantises, release them onto the plant, and they will eat all the bad bugs. Bugs aren't the only ones that can harm your plant. Rain, wind, and cold temperatures also do damage to your plant. Rain can do more harm than good for your plant. If it is raining, bring your plant inside or use a cover like an umbrella to protect it. Also, for cold temperatures, wrap your plants or bring your plants indoors for the night. Winds can also do damage to your plant. It is important that your plant is tied down to a tomato cage or to sticks. This is important to cage your plant during transplanting, as I explained in episode 2. By tying down your plant well, I have seen my plants handle 15 mile per hour winds. Your plant needs protection from infestations. If you see your leaves turn lighter green or yellowish, you should cut the leaf off or else it will infect the stem and eventually the roots. Never trim your plant more than 30% of the leaves at a time. So you don't want to cut it here because a little bit of the stem is going to die. You get what I'm saying when you cut it? So if you cut it too close, then the stem that you just cut is going to get a little brown and it could affect the main stem.
Oh, okay.
So you want to cut it in the middle right here, because it's going to turn brown like a little, like a centimeter. Like for example, if I cut it here, it's going to turn brown up until here. But if I would cut it here, it would have made the stem turn brown. It's more likely for infection. Watch episode 5 for the final stages of growing your cannabis plant from flowering to harvest. Like and subscribe to my channel for more step-by-step videos on how to grow your own outdoor cannabis right at home.